Hi, I welcome you all to this session on payroll management. In the last session, we discussed about some of the important input types relating to payroll. In this session, we are going to discuss or we are going to understand some of the concepts relating to payroll management, that is called payroll drivers, time drivers, and JV simulations. So this is a SAP HCM screen. So for payroll driver, we will use two of the T code PC00 underscore M40 underscore CALC, and another also we will use this for simulation purpose PC00 underscore M40 underscore CALC underscore CMU. So both the screens we will see PC00 underscore M40 underscore CALC. So this is for CALC. So we will create another sessions. Okay, we will create another session PC00 underscore M40 underscore CALC underscore simu SIM means simulations. Okay, we'll see this. Okay, so let us compare, let us see both the screens. Okay, so this is for simulations purpose, this is for test run purpose. Okay, both we'll close one. So this is for simulations purpose. So what are the difference in the screen? Let us see, let us observe. This is for payroll drivers India. Okay, so since we are configuring for India, so this is the payroll driver for India. For different country like United States and UK, there are different payroll drivers because they will have different calculations. So all these things will reflect here, the configuration like IT, all these things in result reports, all these things will. So we'll see this. This is payroll area, and here you see this is test run is disabled here in case of simulations. Okay, so here in case of CALC, no simulations, so it is enabled. If you want, we can also disable. This option is here. These are the two basic difference that we have. So what does it mean? So when we want to execute live run, this tick mark. So this has to be that unticked. We should remove this. Okay, this is required. Understood? So we are processing a regular payroll. Okay, what is a regular payroll? Means month end we are processing. We are also processing some of the off cycle on demand payroll. Okay, what is on demand payroll? On demand payroll as and when it is needed. Okay, suppose we have to execute payroll in the middle of the month, such as take for example that paying bonus to the employees or any sort of ad hoc payment, or someone left in the middle of the month and he wants the full and final settlement. So sometimes for this actually this has to be different. Okay, so these are the things. So we can see also this schema. Schema, it is for IN, you can see India, IN00 is for India, HR, IN, India payroll schema. Okay, so transfer payroll account from table this. So these are the things. So we can see this screen, payroll area. Okay, payroll area, what is the payroll, or whether it is for current period or other, any other period, or we can select the particular partner number, a persons, or payroll area. Payroll area wise also at a time we can run on the payroll for a particular payroll area in the people who are working, who belong to a certain payroll area. Their data can be, payroll can be processed here, or individual employee we can process. Payroll regions, we can state the regions here. Okay, like advance payment, bonus, reimbursement we can see. Okay, so here also we can see on cycle or off cycle. Off cycle that I talked about, like somebody in the pool and final settlement kind of things, okay, or bonus payment middle of the month, okay. So that is not regular. Okay, so this is schema. Okay, forced accounting concept we have discussed. So these are for the actually log for display purpose. These are for display purpose. Normally when we run, we don't display all these things because it will be very elaborative. Like suppose in a company like with 50,000 employees are working, that so there will be long list of the details, therefore we don't display. It is not required. So whenever it is required for individual report, we can display. So this is payroll driver. Then you will see like how to create a new obsessions, like yeah, we can see the new obsessions like we can create. Suppose take for example, we will go for a new sessions. SBG access for obsession means on demand, when and when the payroll processing is required. It is not regular, maybe in the middle of the month. So we will see like POC underscore 40. Yes, so you can see this is for off cycle work wins. Actually this is for the irregular kind of payroll that is not regular. Suppose we can see this is the screen. Okay, so for the pool and final settlement, somebody is living in the middle of the month. For that we can see, so we can check here payroll entry partner number, take for example, let us it is not, because the system is not properly configured, because there is a lot of things have to be settled or configured in order to run. So we can see this here, what shows actually, if you see basically this will see, when you click on payroll, this will see the regions. Okay, regions for settlement, whether it is bonus or it is payment debt, two things it will appear. Actually it should appear, it is not appearing because it is not properly configured, because this actually in this payroll that apart from HCM consultant, payroll consultant also finance team also from operations and finance consultant has to work, since the is not truly configured, therefore it is not coming. Okay, so therefore we are not going to execute payroll, but however we'll see some of the tabs. Okay, so another thing also we should remember, that is that country specific schema I have already shown you, that is IN00. Some of the finance, as some of the financial component, finance part is missing in this training system. There is no symbolic account as well here, therefore we have constraint of executing this PR driver or payroll drivers. Okay, so let us see the next driver, time drivers. We will see. Okay, time driver, what is the time driver? That is for PT60. Okay, see, this is just as our payroll driver has certain kind of schema, time driver has also certain kind of schema. Okay, so we can see this is most frequently used. Schemas are here like TM00, TM01, TM02, 04, like that. These are time evaluations with personal time event, time evaluations for work schedule deviation, time evaluations for external services management, time evaluation without clock times. These are the actually four schema. Actually these are frequently used for the purposes. Okay, so uh, Just as we have schema for payroll, and likewise we have also schema for time evaluation here. Okay, these are the standard schema that we talked about. We use TM 00, 01, 02, 04 like that, respect to evaluations. So then we will see some of the parts of JBC simulations. Like for JBC simulations, we can use like JBC simulation for posting. Actually, who does the posting work? That is actual finance team does the posting work. And that will PC00 underscore PC00 underscore M99 underscore CIPE. Let us see. Yes, this is actually related to posting to accounts that we are, I think you can see, I have shown you here, I was showing some of the important aspects. These are the things, actual process, okay. JBL simulations, okay. Payroll control record, first we have to process, then payroll driver, then payroll test run, then payroll status, then JB simulations. After that, when JBL simulations is finance team says it is okay, then we can exit it. Then finally, the salary will be dispersed. So these are the aspects actually that we have already talked about. So here JBC simulation, you can see for the period, okay, for the current period or what kind of period or other period. So payroll area, we can write about the payroll area. So I have created this payroll area, but I cannot execute now because so many components are missing here, because it's running one SAP and that system, actually it's a teamwork. Therefore, I will not be able to. So here we can put the partner number or payroll area. So area wise we can post, or we can also post individual wise for partner number. It's off cycle that I was talking about, when and where, when it is on demand, that or it may be bonus or ad hoc payment that can be released at the middle of the month, or a person is leaving and full and final settlement is being done at that time. So specific posting date according to period definition. So these are the options. Okay. So this is important. Like we need to check JB simulations related to error. So this will identify if certain kind of error exists in payroll drivers. Okay. So this is one type of document creations. So we can see, so P for live posting run, S for creation of simulations documents, and this is for test run. So what is the purpose? Accordingly we can select this, whether we want to test run, we can make it options, we can select this, or simulation documents, we can make it like that. Okay, so these are the options actually. So let us make a quick recap of what we have seen as part of payroll. First of all, we have to update the master data. Number one, we have to update the whatever master data that we want to update. Like take for example that master data as far as payroll is concerned, there are so many inputs like tax sessions, okay, tax calculations, savings, all these things proposed. We can update all those things. Then we can go for time evaluations. Using PT60, T code PT60. Then time evaluation will give us, or will generate B2 cluster that will give us the number of pay days. So once this number of pay days we know, then we are going to change this in payroll control record. Okay, using PO03. So here we will see the, we are changing the payroll status, we are checking errors through payroll simulations, payroll simulations, we are correcting in the master data. If no error is found, we are putting payroll control record on release mode, okay. And or we release the payroll. Once live payroll is run, RT, that is result tables, and cumulative result table, that is called CRT, are generated. Immediate to generations of RT and CRT, we are asking the finance team to do GP simulations. We are asking the finance team to do JP simulations. What they do, they check if there are certain kind of errors. Okay, if errors found, once again going back, check the control record and making the modification in master data, again perform live run. Okay, and ask the finance team, when finance team reconfirms to HR
regarding no error,
that means there is no error, we need to exit payroll. Okay, so this is important. Exiting payroll is important. Once PRE or payroll is exited, JB simulation will immediately, the JB will be okay, will immediately be posted, and salary statement is generated and sent to the factor. So this is how, actually this is the process. So we should bear in mind the process. Okay, so starting from master data, time evaluation, B2 clusters, then PR control record or payroll control record, and then checking errors, test run, live run, all these things, and finally, so this is indeed a teamwork that to that we understand. Unless the team members that work out very effectively as per the requirement, so it is indeed one sensitive area as well. So the team members have to perform their respective roles in order to that release the payroll, release and exit the payroll. So thank you very much for the sessions. Thank you. Hopefully the that sessions that I have made will be useful for you all. Thank you.